Namaskar. Today I will try to explain something very important in the path of spiritual development. That something very important is called initiation. When we are born, according to yogic philosophy, when you are born first time means before you were something else, like a monkey, like a dog, like a cow, something like that. And now you evolved and you acquired the status of a human being. So it says, Janmana Jayate Shudra. It means from the very beginning, from outset of human existence, you are Shudra. Shudra means animal-like, materialistic person. Here I want to explain that it is not connected with any caste system. Like in India, there is a caste system. So actually, the spiritual worldview doesn't accept the caste system. Because, you know, in a very simple family, a genius can be born. So we are these characteristics, these names like Shudra, etc., is by the quality, is not by birth. Okay? So this, I want to give this clarification first. So, Janmana Jayate Shudra, the very first time you are born in human body, you are Shudra, means materialistic person. Materialistic is, I exist. Only I exist. This world is for me. It's objective world. I don't feel it as a living entity. I don't have any connection. I just use it. I use it for my pleasure. So that kind of mentality. I live for pleasure. I live for, you know, I need a house, I need a car, I need a wife, I need to go somewhere. This kind of mentality. Enjoying the material life without a tiny spark of spirituality. That state is called Shudra or materialistic state. I also want to say that when I say materialist, it means materialist by nature, not by ideology. Like some people, they believe in materialism. They think that the matter, you know, many scientists, they are materialists by ideology. They don't believe in God. But by nature, they are not. Like many people, they are not believers, but they are happy to serve humanity. They are hungry for knowledge. They want to be good. They want to evolve. They want to develop. These are not the characteristic of the Shudra. They are not the characteristic of a materialist. They are characteristics of a very developed person. So here, Shudra means materialist by nature. And he may believe in God, but he doesn't care for God. He doesn't care for consciousness. He doesn't care for aesthetics. He doesn't care for beatitude, for bliss, for knowledge. What he cares for? Entertainment, bread and butter, safety, you know, nice house, nice job, this kind of things. So Janmane Jayate Shudra, everybody at the first birth, he is like that. You were like that, I was like that, everybody. And of course also every child, you know, when we are born, first years of our existence, we are all materialistic. We only need material things. And then later on, if I have a previous experience, if my consciousness already evolved to that point when I become spiritual, then that child, he, this desire for greatness awakens in him. Because of the past experience, because of the past lives. So some child will awaken to spirituality and some child will not. Because he doesn't have that experience. Okay? So Janmana Jayate Shudra. Everybody from birth is Shudra. Then, Samskara Dvija Uchyate. Going through renewal, you become Dvija or twice born. It means you are not the first time here. You have been already you have gotten experience, and then remember that I exist, only I exist. This world is for me. And then this world is just like a divine washing machine. You are thrown into that divine washing machine, and the machine is washing you. You know, in the washing machine, you go up and down, up and down, up and down. So you go like that. So sometimes you feel happy, sometimes you shed your tears, and you just start to feel like, I'm not managing. So you invoke the Supreme Force. Oh, divine entity, help me. But still, next realization comes. I exist and you exist. But you need God to benefit you. Still materialistic. Means, God, please give me car. God, give me house. This kind of attitude. Then, you know, the washing machine is working. And then, I don't know, this joys of life, they start to lose the charm. So many times I've been here, but I do not, so many times I enjoyed, so many times I suffered. But really, I want to have something subtler, something more beautiful. I'm not really enjoying the way my soul wants. I get all those pleasures, but is it all the life can offer? So this kind of consciousness starts to awaken in me. So then there is a third stage. You exist and I exist. O Supreme Entity, O Supreme Happiness, you exist and I exist. And I'm moving around you. I am now searching you. I'm not wanting something from you, but I want to search you. In one of the videos before, I spoke about three factors of evolution. Just because of the nature of matter, there are forces, interactions in the matter. There is constant clash and cohesion going on in the matter. And more complicated the structure, the more intense this fight of inner forces is going on. And during that fight, part of matter, some tiny little fraction of matter is transformed into a subtler part. That part we call mind. And then that is called physical clash. Then on the next level, when one idea clashes with another idea, that there is a crude idea, there is a subtle idea, they clash, thesis, antithesis, synthesis. So your mind becomes elevated due to the contact with the greater idea. That's called intellectual clash. So these are like a mechanical forces. You are being bombarded with different conflicts, intellectual conflicts, the survival, the struggle for survival. So in that process, you're developing. And then a sparkle of divinity is produced. And then you start to desire. A strange desire comes to you. I don't know. I want something great. I want something infinite. That is becoming truly human. So it says, Samskarat Dvidja Uchate. Going through renewal, going through the cosmic washing machine, living life, experiencing ups and downs, you become Dvidja, twice born. So many lives you've been in that washing machines. Twice means not first time. At least second time, but most probably it is already 15 times or already 100 times, God knows. So and then you become Dvidja. Dvidja means expressing desire to be human, expressing desire to be spiritual. Then next stage, Veda Patat Bharat Vipra. Through studies of Veda, in this context, it doesn't mean any particular scripture, like Veda, Rigveda, Atharvaveda, Samaveda, Yajurveda, not those scriptures. Just Veda means knowledge. By acquiring knowledge, the science, knowledge about the world, spiritual knowledge, what person becomes? He becomes Vipra. Veda patat bhavet Vipra. Vipra means enlightened person, intellectual person. So Veda patat bhavet Vipra. And then finally, Brahma janati Brahmana. Knowing Brahma, knowing Supreme Consciousness, he becomes Brahmana, the God-realized person. That's the real meaning of Brahmana. It's not the caste, it's not hereditary. It's not like you are born and in the family already you automatically. No. You have to acquire it. So now I will come to that, how to acquire. So part of the process is just like, you know, a lump of clay, and inside there is a tiny human being, a sculpture of a human being, and a lump of clay. You put it in the washing machine and it goes like that. So slowly, slowly the clay is washing away, the clay is washing away, the clay is washing away. And then this human being appears. So that is the Dvija stage. That is a Vipra stage. Slowly, slowly you become aware of your human purpose. Why I am living? What is this life for? And then Brahma Janati Brahmana. Then you receive initiation, then you become Brahmana. Okay, now about initiation. So English word initiation. It means to initiate, to start something. To start to move along a new avenue of progress. But this original word for initiation, because in English there is no such word. But in Sanskrit there is Diksha. This word is much deeper than initiation. So Diksha. Dipagyanam jato. Dadyat kuryat papakshayam tata. Tasma dikshetis apракта sarvatantrasya samata. That's the definition of initiation. Anyway, I'm actually going too fast. I should speak a little more before that. So initiation. Okay, there is this process of washing. That's a kind of mechanical process. You're evolving just by living your life. Going through ups and downs, slowly, slowly, you awaken to spirituality because of that. Now, at certain stage, a knowledge imparted to you. How to ask the divine to reveal you the secrets of the universe? That is called Vediki Diksha, Vaidiki Diksha, the Diksha of the Vedas. You are given the knowledge. How to request the divine, how to develop the desire to become spiritual. Everything, it's like the studying of scriptures is also part of Vedic process, Vediki Diksha. But the very essence of Vediki Diksha is this mantra. Om Bhur Bhuva Svaha Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dhyoyona Prachodayat. It means Om Bhur Bhuva Svar. O Creator, who has created the seven layers of existence, such as Bhur, the physical, Bhuvar, the plane of becoming, where the things are not yet manifested, but they are about to manifest. Svar, the mental plane of the cosmic existence, and like this, Janar, Tapar, Satya, Mahar, yeah. You know, it says like seventh heaven. That kind of expression comes from this concept, Saptaloka. So, Om Bhur Bhuvar Svaha O Creator, who has created all those planes of existence, Tat Savitur Varenyam, that divine Son, adorable, worthy of our adoration, Tat Savitur, Savita means Son, Tat Saviturum, that Son, Varenyam, worthy of our adoration, Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi, we meditate on your divine effulgence. And why do we meditate on your divine effulgence? Tat Savitur Varenyam, Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi, Dyo Yonah Prachodayat. Please, connect our mind with the spirit of welfare. Let our mind be guided by the spirit of welfare. Let we become good. Guide us on the path of goodness. Guide us to you, to discover you. So this very spirit of this mantra is O divine entity. I told in one of the previous videos that a great magician exists, and this universe is the great magical show. So first you're really fascinated with that magical show. It's like, wow, you cannot turn your eyes away of that magical show. Because it's so captivating, so great. But then you have seen it like 1,000 times. You're like, okay, now this thing is coming. Okay, now this thing is coming. It's not like you're not fascinated anymore. You know, the washing machine is working. Ups and downs, and this magical show start to lose its charm. So now, you want to stop seeing the magic, you want to start seeing the magician. You want to know the magician, you want to know the secrets behind this apparent show. So why people, they study, they go to this, you know, like in Switzerland, there is this huge the particle accelerator, and then they bump the particles and look, what's going on there? Not like this look, but with the instruments and tools, scientific tools. What if we break the particles? What if we break the matter? What is going to be there? So it's like an unconscious desire to know God, to know the divine, what is inside. So I'm tired of seeing this show. I'm tired to seeing this apparent world. I want to see the causal world. I want to see the world which is behind that, the spiritual arena, the divine world, the transcendental world. So I'm not looking at the magic, I'm looking at the magician. So I'm requesting magician. I know that his Maya, his magic force is so strong. If he doesn't want me to know, I will never be able to know his secrets. So he has to explain me the secrets. So I am asking him, Om Bhurbhuvah Svaha Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dyo Yona Prachodayat. O divine entity, guide me on the path of happiness. I don't know, I tried so hard, you know, every time I go up, I think I will be happy. But actually not, this is not what I want. O divine entity, what is the secret? I want to know the secret. Actually, you are requesting for the second stage. So, Vaidiki Diksha, where you request the divine. What is the result? The result is surrender. The result is feeling that I am ready to go after you, follow you. Reveal me the secrets, and I will do what you teach me. Not I, but you. You exist, and I exist. And the final stage will be you exist, only you exist. When I learned the secrets, I understand that there is no magic. There is only the magician. So now, I am at that stage of awakening. So the Vedic Diksha produces in me this desire to become a follower, to become a disciple. Before I was, I exist, the maximum ego. This world is for me. I don't even recognize that there are living things there. Everything is just objective. objects, not the subjects. Maximum ego. Then slowly, you know, washing machine is working, the ego. ego start to crumble. Oh yeah, I exist, but you also exist. Then it gives a crack. You exist and I exist. And then finally ego disappears. Only you exists. Only you exist. So then the next process starts. Vidiki Diksha, you were asking. Like, I know many people, they were chanting this Om Bhurbhuvah Svaha. And then very shortly we met and I gave them Tantric Diksha. But before they were chanting, like for 3 months or maybe one year they were chanting. Also like Baba Nam Kevalam. Not exactly, but it is a kind of mixture of Vedic and Tantric Diksha. So you are watching the lectures, you are trying the first type of meditation, simple kind of meditation. You are developing the desire. Slowly, slowly your heart becomes refined. And then you just want, one day you feel, you know, I want to follow the path. I want to become a disciple. I want to know all the secrets of the divine. I want to know the purpose of life. I want to know myself. So then the time has come. So either this Om Bhurbhuvah Svaha or like Baba Nam Kevalam, I was teaching on this channel, no? You do some basic meditation. So after some preparation, then you receive Tantric Diksha. Tantric Diksha means Dipagyanam Jato Dadyat Kuryat Papakshayam Tata Tasmadishet Saprakta Sarvatantrasya Samata. Dipagyanam. What is Dipagyana? Dipagyana means a torch, light. Light of knowledge. First part is ideological. What is the purpose of life? Who am I? What is my role? Where I'm going? What is the purpose of life? This is one kind of light. The answer to those questions is one kind of light of knowledge. It's ideological, motivational, and then practical. So if the goal, let's say you come to God, okay? He said, God, give me happiness. He said, okay, how much? This much? You like, no, little more. This much? How much? Then if you think a little bit, this much. So if you think, we have infinite need in our entity. We want infinity and eternity. So to embrace infinity and eternity, our mind has to become infinite. So, where is the practical process? Like, I did the video on the third eye, and many people, they expressed, like, they said, like, so, how? I think it's very clear, but somehow this evades people. So how to open the third eye? So that how is embedded in the Tantric Diksha. What to do practically, step by step? You sit like this, you do like that, you do like that. A secret process where you, the secrets, the deepest secrets, and some people, why secret? Because it is secret. Because it is the deepest secret of the universe. And then only when the time comes, you will be allowed to know that secret. Where you have become mature for that, then the opportunity will arise for you to learn. So Dipagyanam, that kind of knowledge, precise process, how to follow, how to reveal the goal of life, how to see the magician. How not to see the magic? Turn away from the magic. What is the process? What is the exact method to see the magician? Okay? Then another side is Dadyat Kuryat Papakshayam Tata. Papa means sin or some harmful action. When we do some harmful action, when we harm somebody, then I do something, you know, action comes out of me and changes something in the external world. At the same time, it changes something in the internal world. There is action-reaction. So, the moment I have done harm to somebody, it cracks my mind, it cracks my soul. It creates a certain cloud in my mind. And because of that cloud, I am not able to see. So we have so many different complexes, we have so many different mentalities because of those clouds. Like, for example, person will marry, then divorce, then marry again, then again divorce, then marry again. And each marriage, he will experience the same kind of problem because it is the same cloud in the mind. So, Papa Kshayam, Papa means sin, and that the reaction of the action, of the harmful action, stays in the mind and clouds your vision, not allowing you to see the spirituality. It's like you are in a car and your entire glass, you know, the front glass, is full of mud. You cannot see. So the sun is there, but you cannot see the sun because of that mud. So without removing that mud, you cannot really progress in spirituality. So Papa Kshayam, Kshayam means waning, disappearing, thinning. So Papa Kshayam, disappearing of sins. So it becomes Dipagyanam, Di, and then Papa Kshayam, Ksha, Di, Ksha, together. Дикша. Дипагьянам. Папакшаям. So the process which gives you the light of knowledge, how to move on the spiritual path, and also the energy that fries the samskaras. Samskaras, they are like seeds in the mind that cloud the mind. So you need to fry those seeds. What means frying? It's like, I give you example. I come to the shop, and then I ask something the shopkeeper, and then the shopkeeper, in a very rude way, he rebukes me. He says, who am I? Information bureau? To give, you know, information to every Dick, Tom, and Harry. So that kind of, I got this kind of rebuke, I feel pain, and then I retaliate. I say, who you think you are? You are just, you know, miserable shopkeeper. Something like this I tell, no? So it becomes the provocation. It comes because of the mind seeks restoration of balance. To remove the consequences of painful actions, I need to feel pain myself. Then the mind becomes cleansed. And then, you know, I'm free from that. But when I got provoked, I felt pain. I respond to that pain by humiliating that person again. So out of one seed, many similar. And then I came home, then I slapped my dog. And, you know, I break a plate or something like that. You know, I was angry. So one seed can create many, many, many harmful actions. So out of one seed of wheat, it can become 10 seeds of wheat. Out of 10 seeds of wheat can become 100 seeds of wheat. Huh? The grains. So out of one grain, it can be a million grains in the end. So burning, frying those seeds means acquiring the divine knowledge, divine happiness. So even when provoked, you don't feel like retaliating. You don't feel like going on in that endless circle of action and reaction. So such person is called Dagda Bija, or burnt seed. So during initiation, during Diksha, you receive that kind of impulse, that kind of energy, spiritual energy, and that energy starts cleansing the mind. removing all different illusions, delusions, different kinds of misunderstandings, so you can progress. That's why after initiation, the progress is very fast. It goes very, very fast. You're going through so many experiences, like that pleasant, painful, but your mind becomes very, very clear, very fast. So, dipagyanam jato. First, there has to be knowledge, proper knowledge, how to move, how to meditate, how to achieve the goal of life. And then there has to be force, cleansing the mind, cleansing the mind, cleansing the mind. So, during initiation, you receive these two. Knowledge and then the force. In the mantra itself, in the personal mantra itself, there is this power to clean the mind. And then all tantras, they agree that this is the process of initiation and this is the fundamental necessity on the spiritual path. We can also further subdivide the initiation to like three important things. One is dipani, means the light, already I spoke about it. It's the technique of meditation. Then goes mantra aghat. Mantra aghat means the strike of the mantra. The mantra strikes at the root of your existence, where the sleeping divinity is, kundalini shakti. In the lowermost bone of your spine dwells the divine force. If that force is awakened and rises, your consciousness becomes enlightened. So to awaken that force, there has to be a special sound that resonates, that comes in touch with that force. It interacts with that force. Not any kind of sound, but special sound for you. So that special sound, a trained person called Acharya, is able to find for you and then give you. And then the mantra strikes your sleeping divinity and it awakens. And then that is mantra aghat, just the sound, the power of the sound. So listen to the sound, it's very important to listen to the sound. And then mantra chaitanya. Mantra chaitanya means ideation. The meaning of the mantra, the import of the mantra. Dipani, the process of the knowledge that brings you to the concentration, helps you to realize the meaning of the mantra. And then mantra chaitanya. Mantra chaitanya is intellectual understanding of the mantra. Emotional drive, emotional feeling like, I want to discover the divine. This kind of feeling, that kind of ideation, that kind of bhava, that is also. And then the grace of the guru. Guru is a spiritual entity that stands in the foundation of the spiritual tradition. And then through the disciples, through acharyas, that tradition is carried forth. So that mantras received from the guru, they are being carried as a living energy, and they are transmitted to the next generation of disciples, again and again, again and again. But that energy comes from the root of the divine being that incarnates on the earth. Such divine being we call Guru. Or we can call Guru Deva, like a divine dispeller of darkness, like that. So that mantra Chaitanya, the force of Guru, your desire, your understanding of the mantra, your ideation, plus Dipani has done the work, you have brought, you came out of the physical world, you came out of your body, you came out of your thoughts, and you completely turned from magic to the magician, that's Dipani. And then mantra Aghat, the power of the sound, awakens the potential. Now the potential is ready to manifest. And then mantra Chaitanya, uplifting your spiritual potential, and you become enlightened. So that is a process. That's the Diksha imparts these things to you. Dipani, mantra Chaitanya, mantra Aghat. So, yeah, nothing much more to say. I believe that if you are watching our videos, if you are sincere in your meditation efforts, sooner or later you will have this feeling, you will have this desire. I want to now I really feel like I want to be disciple. I want to be follower. I want to follow the spiritual path. And I want to be happy. Because that type of happiness is not what I really want. I want something beyond this world, something out of this world, something greater, something so great, which is infinite. So when do you have that desire? It said, Mukhtya Kaunkaya Sadguru Prapti. When the desire of liberation awakens in your mind to be liberated spiritual being, then a perfect teacher comes into your life. So when you are ready, then you can contact our support team, and then you can receive also. But normally I give the condition you practice 100 hours of Bhavanam Kevalam first. Means you clock the time of your meditations, and sum of your meditations time should be at least 100 hours. And then we can meet, or I can advise you a person near your location, who one of my brothers in spirituality or sisters, and then you can learn. And to me it's like a beginning of the golden age, because all the clouds from the mind, they just disappear, and just you see the world with the different eyes, with the different feelings. The inner world is much richer than the external world. What is external world? When you have that richness inside, then the external world also. Like, I love the forest very much. I look at the tree and it makes me blissful. But before I didn't see that eyes to see the bliss emanating from the tree. And now I have. Because of that cleansing of the mind with the mantra, with the force, with the spiritual force. So I hope it was interesting for you. Namaskar. And I think I have promised you to explain this topic. Now I have fulfilled the promise. Namaskar.